A good Samaritan tries to help out two men and ends up stabbed a dozen times. In his desperation for help, it's what happens next that may shock you. Only on 7, Action 7 News reporter Liz McKernan has the story. But we do want to warn you, you may find some of the images you are about to see disturbing.
Here in this quiet Northwest subdivision, the unthinkable happened.
Just didn't know how to react, wouldn't even be able to put it in words.
Ron Ritchie is now replacing his carpet and furniture after a desperate late-night intrusion. Police say 40-year-old Paul Mueller was stabbed, carjacked, and left for dead in the cul-de-sac after two men asked for a ride home to escape the cold night.
I feel disappointed in the world. I just, like, it's not okay. He stabbed me. He was so cold. He had no emotion. It was very businesslike.
Mueller spoke with us from the hospital and told us his night got even worse. He pounded on at least three doors looking for help, but no one would answer. So in desperation, he smashed Richie's front window with a rock, climbed through the broken glass, and struggled up the stairs begging for help.
The whole front of the house was splattered in blood.
How disturbing was that to see that?
Very disturbing. Very disturbing. And then, you know, the inside of the house was pretty bloody as well.
Richie's photos show how dire the situation was. Blood spilling from the dozens of stab wounds that had Mueller wondering if he would live to see his children again.
I felt like I was a criminal doing something wrong, like there was no love in the world and that I wasn't worth saving. I wasn't even worth waking up for. I wasn't worth opening a door for.
Now, this good Samaritan says he's lost all faith in humanity.
Well, I didn't have much faith in it before, but what little I did, absolutely, absolutely, I feel like what happened to the world? There is no love in the world.
Liz McKernan, KOAT, Action 7 News.
Police are still looking for the two suspects in their late teens to early 20s. The victim's black 2011 Jeep Wrangler is still missing. Anyone with information is asked to call Albuquerque.